Hello everyone. A while ago I made a video called How to Play Drums. In that video I explained the most basic groove of rock music. The groove I showed you in my last video was in 4/4 time. Since most rock music is in 4/4, this groove works for most rock songs. However, there are also some songs that use a different feel, different groove, a different time signature. Some of these most common time signatures are 3/4, 6/8 or 12/8. I don't want to talk too much about numbers in this video though, so I would like to show you how to get to these grooves and these different feels from where we left off in the last video. So let's get started. It is called 4/4 because there are 4 quarter notes in one bar. So basically you can count to 4 every bar. If I slow down the groove, this gets easier to hear and see. Every quarter note gets divided into 2 equal parts. Now, notice how much the feel of the music changes if I play 3 hi-hat strokes on every bass drum and on every snare drum. This groove, or variations of this groove, were used in many songs. A famous example is Nothing Else Matters by Metallica.
Open myself this way. Life is ours, we live it our way. All these words I don't just say, and nothing else matters. Rust I seek and I find in you.
With this groove you can already accompany a lot of songs. But this is not all you can do with the idea of dividing every beat into 3 equal parts. Let's speed up the groove a little and see how it feels. So let's make sure that we understand what exactly is going on here. With a groove of Hold the Line, you can again count along. You can count to 4 in every bar. On the beat of 1 and 3 there's a bass drum, on the beat of 2 and 4 there's a snare drum. So this didn't change. The only thing that changed is that we play 3 strokes on the hi-hat now on every strong beat instead of 2. And from this groove, the jump to a shuffle groove is very small. Coming from Hold the Line, I want to explain how to get to the shuffle feel. And it will sound complicated when I put it into words, but if you listen to the music, it will make perfect sense, so please bear with me. What I do now is I look at the hi-hat, I look at this group of 3 that I play on the hi-hat on every strong beat. Yeah, we had 3 hi-hat strokes on every bass drum, 3 hi-hat strokes on every snare drum. And now what I will do is leave out the second one of these 3 hi-hat strokes. So instead of playing 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, I will leave out the 2. 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 3, 1, 3, 1, 3, 1, 3, 1. So we still divide every strong beat into 3 equal parts, but we don't play the second part. It is kind of imaginary. So once again, this is the transition from the groove of Hold the Line to a shuffle groove. The only thing that changes is the hi-hat pattern. With this shuffle groove, you can do a lot of interesting things. Of course, you don't have to keep the shuffle groove in the hi-hat. You can also put it in the bass drum. Another very common thing to do with a shuffle groove is to put the shuffle pattern into the snare drum. This is a little complicated to play though, because it's important to still hear the 2 and the 4 in the snare drum. So you have to play with 2 different volumes in the left hand. A famous rock song that uses this kind of groove is La Grange by ZZ Top. Another thing drummers often do with a shuffle is to put the missing note, so the second one of this grouping of 3, the note that we left out in the hi-hat pattern, to put this one into the snare drum pattern. So then again you hear the full pattern of the 3 eighth notes on every quarter note, but you hear it divided between the hi-hat and the snare drum. I would like to give you some more song examples for famous shuffle grooves. However, some of the most famous shuffle grooves are halftime shuffles. So, what is a halftime shuffle? Or first, What is halftime? Well, basically I play the same groove, but in half the tempo. However, only the bass drum and the snare drum play half the tempo. The hi-hat stays the same. So I stretch the two bass drum strokes and the two snare drum strokes over two bars instead of over one bar. If I still count then in my original frequency, so I still count 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. The old groove was ta, 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 ta. I now play it in half the tempo. This means that in the first bar, I play a bass drum on the 1 and the snare drum on the 3. In the second bar, I also play the bass drum on the 1 and the snare drum on the 3. Then it sounds like this. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Ta. Ta. So you can hear that the groove is played in half the tempo. If you now change the bass drum pattern slightly and open the hi-hat sometimes, you get the groove that is played by John Bonham on Led Zeppelin's tune Fool in the Rain. One of the most famous shuffles is the Purdy Shuffle. It was invented by Bernard Purdy. Probably the most famous example of a halftime shuffle is the groove of Rosanna, played by Jeff Porcaro of Toto. There's a video of Jeff explaining how he came up with this iconic groove. And he took some inspiration from both the Purdy Shuffle and the groove of Fool in the Rain. That was it for today. Hopefully this video has helped you to understand a little bit more about the different fields of music. Maybe it even gave you some inspiration or new ideas for new grooves. Please let me know in the comments if you would like me to continue with this little explaining series. Thank you very much for watching all the way through and have a lovely week. Bye bye.